Bullock's pass deflected, stopped by Brendan Moore. Over 4 minutes gone by in the third. Flyers with a 4-3 lead. Bob Corkum is taken out by Aaron Gaby. Played to the side of the net. Lindros pass. Good play by David Shaw as Brendan Moore was set up in front. Isobar plays it in.
And for Michael Renberg, his first point since January 15th.
Be back, huh?
They need him.
Well, he had a serious problem with the tendon in the pelvic bone. A lot of rest. He tried to come back. He re-injured it, re-aggravated it, and then sat out until late in the season, played the last two games of the regular season. And here's a chance for Jason Weimer, and it's smothered by Hextall. Hextall missed on the poke check, but the puck slid under his body.
He timed it perfectly. And what passing by the Lightning, and Weimer just simply could not catch up to the puck. The Lightning moving quickly. Here's Weimer right up the front. Look at him just reach for it. Hextall dives out and actually is able to just beat Weimer to it. But watch the puck. Right there, he doesn't see it. And his defenseman is able to come in and just tuck the puck underneath him.
They made a correction on the Lindros goal. It's now Dykhouse gets the assist, not Howardchuk. So it's Lindros from Dykhouse and Renberg at 3:20.
I think they'll change that. It was Howardchuk that took the shot.
That's right. They have to. Sure. It has to be Howardchuk.
Why would they do that?
All right. A little confusion in Florida. Still getting
They're still learning.
Out. That's right. Up the boards, cleared out by Brian Bellows. Back for it. Lindros races to the puck. Whacked by Petit. Big chop by Petit. Looks like he got the stick. And not Eric Lindros. Renberg. Across to Svoboda. Puck deflected off the glass and caroms up into the crowd, stopping play. 14-19 in this third period. For the Lindros, Howardchuk, Renberg line, 4 points.
And it's been a difficult day because Eric Lindros has drawn so much attention. But you know what? He's gotten up from a lot of those hits. Roman Hammerlich he takes down there. And then Lindros actually ends up moving in and ends up with a scoring chance for the Flyers. But they have stayed very, very close to Lindros in this game, and the Flyers they've been staying with it. They haven't lost their cool. Jeff Reese has been strong in goal for the Lightning.
Bradley leaves it. Zamer shot into Ron Hextall, and he holds it, leaving nothing for the Lightning to get to. Pushing Rob Zamer and Peter Svoboda pushed apart.
Well, we've seen a game here that has had a number of different stages, with Philadelphia getting off to the quick lead. Jeff Reese let in a soft goal, the first goal by Joel Otto. But the Lightning, you know, just at times when they seemed to maybe like they didn't have it and the Flyers were slowly taking over this game, they'd come right back, score some big goals. They were down by 2 goals, came back to tie it. And here they are again now in this third period with 14 minutes to go, down by a goal again.
But still in it. They came back in the third period in Philadelphia to tie that game and won it in overtime in game two. Svoboda for Sean Cordin. Svoboda tries the other side. Dykhouse moves it.
In the third period this year, the Lightning have played their best hockey. Goals for, goals against, and shots against have all been their best numbers in the third period.
Zabner played it in front. Dykhouse blocked it. Ulanov to Bradley off his stick. Brindamore able to work it out to Joel Otto. Deflected by Bill Holder into the crowd. Other games this afternoon in the Stanley Cup playoffs. Take a look at the scoreboard. The New York Rangers leading Montreal 2-1 at the Molson Center in Montreal. Detroit has tied Winnipeg in the third period. And look at Calgary coming back. It's now 5-4. It was 5-0. And tonight, Toronto is at St. Louis for game three of their series, which is all even.
Bellows 23 on the bench. Boy, what a job he has done this year. When he was traded from the Montreal Canadiens, he came here and he was told he was going to be a role player and wouldn't get much ice time, but he waited, was patient, and he's had a great season.
Bird in front, a save by Hextall on Isobart. Sean Burr set up Paul Isobart. And Hextall with a big save.
And Hextall made the save and did not know where the puck was. He actually reached behind him. Again, the Lightning coming in, moving the puck very quickly. And Isobart with the last chance. Hextall with the save. Doesn't know where it is. You can see him use his left arm and reach behind him, thinking the puck might be trickling in through the pads. But Hextall was able to squeeze the pads together, hold on to the puck, and the faceoff will come deep in the Flyers' zone.
16 saves for Juan Hextall. Paul Isobart, the first and only captain of the Tampa Bay Lightning, named this year. Their first three seasons, they did not have a captain.
They kept on rotating the A's, and they've had a lot of different veteran players come with this organization for that reason.
Puck around the board. David Shaw keeps it in. Salavanov plays it deep for Isobart. He's checked by Samuelson. Sean Burr moves in. Taken by Chris Therrien. Platt moved it. Otto hooked by Salavanov. Platt pushes it rather. Corkum pushed it to Platt. Platt's got it. Pass deflected by Jeff Reese. And Isobart plays the puck. 12:35 to go in the third. 4-3, Philadelphia leading it. The other three series being played this afternoon are all 2-0, with Montreal, Detroit, and Chicago leading. Here it's one game apiece. The other series we haven't talked about because it's been silent is Florida and Boston. They'll play game two tomorrow night. Florida, we'll be right back. Days off in that series. They'll play again tomorrow night with game two. Three nights of Garth Brooks concerts and today the Miami Heat in the Miami Arena. So unable to play game two until tomorrow night. Florida won game one 6-3. The big performance by John Van Beesbrook in goal. Right here, Philadelphia leading 4-3, just under 12 minutes to go in the third period. Michel Petit holding behind the net. Michael Renberg forechecking for Philadelphia. They have four men back in the neutral zone. Petit played it to the boards to Anderson. Sent back in by Howerchuk. And a whistle for an offside stopping play. Dale Howerchuk has been such an important acquisition for the Flyers.
And he's played just about every position. He had 20 points in the 16 games that he played for the Flyers in the regular season. Of course, he came over from the Blues. He's been an MVP in the league, that back in the 84-85 season. And since coming here to the Flyers, as I mentioned, he's played a lot of different positions. Right wing, tonight he's playing left wing. He's played the point on the power play. And basically what they've done with Howerchuk is when he got here, they said, you go play your game. Handle the puck, make the plays. And he has done that, and everything has worked out splendidly.
And every time you think about players going down, Renberg for such a long period of time. Played out in front, Hextall steers it aside. Now LeClaire is out. And Howerchuk steps up to be such an important part of this team. Dan Quinn with Rod Brindamore. Brindamore for Therrien, saved by Reese. Beautiful passing play by the Flyers, and Reese comes up with a key save. Weimer stopped by Samuelson, stopped by Falloon, and Hamerlick has the puck. Across for Brian Bellows. Samuelson checks Jason Weimer. Therrien moves it around the boards. Brindamore moves up with it. Slowed down by Bradley. Bellows trying to take it back for Tampa Bay. Jeff Reese. Out for Rob Zamener. Pass did not get through. Flyers clear it away. Ulanov gets to it. Igor Ulanov played with Winnipeg and with Washington. And with Chicago, came over in a late season trade with the Chicago Blackhawks. Bradley across, Ulanov is there. Down low, Zamener deflected wide. Nice passing, good hit on that play by Sean Podine. Platt dumps it in. Reese blocked by Otto, but Ulanov moves it up the boards. Shot by Corkum high and wide. Let's go, let's go. Down to Mikael Anderson. stopped by Svoboda.
See Philadelphia playing a little bit more conservative now. If they don't have a good opportunity to get in and forecheck in the Lightning zone, and they just send one man in, they have the other four players back.
Flyers have outshot the Lightning 38-20. Salivanov's shot is on goal, steered aside, knocked aside with the blocker by Ron Hextall. Jim Montgomery trying to clear the zone. Stopped by Paul Izobard. Izobard holds. Plays it down for Salivanov. He's checked by Dykhouse. Brindamore moves it up for Montgomery. Able to clear it out. Jim Montgomery just called up from Hershey with the injuries to John Drews and John LeClair. Montgomery had a fine season in Hershey, but Hershey playing the first round of their playoffs in the American League, now 2-0. Here's Montgomery sending it in. Corey Cross avoids the hit attempt of Bob Corkum. Colin Burr almost gave it away, gets through to Salivanov. Across, offside, is a pass across two lines, and they'll bring it back. 8:58 to go in the third, and the Flyers lead by one. Glad you're with us for the Stanley Cup playoffs on Fox. We'll be back with you next week. Game six, if necessary games. Rangers in Montreal, Pittsburgh and Washington, Detroit, Winnipeg, Chicago and Calgary. Igor Ulanov, number five, back for it. Philadelphia and Tampa Bay will play game four here at the Thunderdome Tuesday night. And they'll go back to Philadelphia for game five Thursday night. Lindros took down Peter Klima. Power check for Lindros. Lindros against Ulanov. Poke check. It was an offside. Whistled on the play, and Lindros bumps with Aaron Gabey. And a little get together. The linesmen do a good job settling things down.
They're trying to stay close to him, aren't they? This is after the whistle. It was Lindros with a little bit of a slash, and he takes another little bit of a stick. He just attracts them like flies, doesn't he? Wherever he goes, whether the play's going on or whether the whistle is blowing the play dead, they just follow the big guy around. And as of right now, he is scored the fourth goal for the Flyers as they lead it 4-3.
He is so talented, so multi-talented. When you have a superstar player like him, you do anything you can to just get him to lose his focus. And thus far, he has kept his focus. And the Flyers have the 4-3 lead with 8:20 to go in the third period. Chris the puck. Nice speed. Weaver shoots just wide. Missed the net on a hard shot. The shot by David Shaw gets through, and Hextall makes the save. And Gratton in front against Hextall. David Shaw with a long shot.
And the Flyers, with a little bit of a defensive mistake, allowed Jason Weimer to walk in on the left wing. Look, see, all the Flyers go to the left. That leaves Weimer open down the left wing, and he took the shot. Did not miss the net by much. Hextall came out to cut down the angle. Weimer just wide with the shot.
It's all over in Montreal. The Rangers win a very important game. It's 2-1 as the Rangers needed that game desperately. Two power play goals by Adam Graves, and the Rangers beat the Montreal Canadiens. They had only won once in their last 21 trips to Montreal. They win 2-1. It's now 2-1 in favor of Montreal with game four Tuesday night at the Molson Center.
That's a huge victory. And the meanwhile, here it is 2-1 right here.
Yeah.
Montreal leads it 2-1.
Oh, nice change there,
Thank
Joe.
Thank you. Montreal leads it 2-1.
How about Washington leading Pittsburgh 2-0? And game three in Washington tomorrow night.
That's a gutsy bunch of players with all kinds of injuries they've had on that team. And to shut down Mario Lemieux and Jaromir Jagr for two games without goals, those two, is a tremendous feat.
If there's a game six in that series, that'll be on Fox. Olaf Kolzig, what a story he's been. Replaced Jim Carrey in game one as Washington rallied 4-1 down to win 6-4. Then Kolzig was the winning goalie, went all the way in game two. Right here, Tampa Bay Lightning down to the Flyers, 4-3. Hanging in there, the big surprise thus far, as they won game two of this series, and they are hanging tough with the Flyers. An icing whistled on Tampa Bay, 7:29 to go in the third. Game four Tuesday night, game five in Philadelphia on Thursday night, and then we get into the if necessary games. Game six back here at Thunderdome Saturday, and game seven, if necessary, would be in Philadelphia a week from Monday.
And Jeff Reese has done a good job. Darren Pupa, as we talked about at the start, is out with back spasms. He has been the backbone of this team. Jeff Reese had to step in, and the two coaches, Terry Crisp on the right, the more emotional guy. You see him back and forth and talking.
What a contrast in styles.
Yeah, tremendous contrast.
Very stoic Terry Murray and the animated Terry Crisp. Trent Platt. Examiner gets to it.
And now what we might see Tampa Bay do here shortly, being down by a goal, we might see their defensemen start moving up on the play offensively a little bit more and taking a few more offensive chances, which could lead to a scoring chance for the Philadelphia Flyers.
It's an icing on Philadelphia with 7:01 to go. They go back down deep into the Flyers zone for the faceoff. This telecast is presented by authority of the National Hockey League. It's intended for the private use of our audience. Any publication, rebroadcast, or other use of the pictures, descriptions, and accounts of this telecast, including the imposition of a charge for viewing the telecast without the express written consent of the National Hockey League, is prohibited.
And this is where the faceoffs become so important now. Rod Brind'Amour taking his faceoff for the Flyers against Brian Bradley deep in the Philadelphia zone.
Now, after a couple chances, I think we have it official now. It's Lindros, the go-ahead goal from Howardchuk and Dykhouse. So no Renberg assist on the goal. Howardchuk does get the assist. So it's two assists for Howardchuk in the game, one for Renberg, and a goal for Erik Lindros.
Now we knew two out of the three.
Yeah. Lindros moving in with the puck, looking to make a pass. He does. Good save by Reese on Renberg's shot. 39 shots on goal for the Flyers. Reese has made 35 saves. Hextall plays it to the corner. Howardchuk lifts it out of the zone. And lifted it over the glass into the crowd, stopping play. 6:33 remaining in this third period.
And again with Tampa Bay in this game, they have rotated four lines for the most part, which is Terry Crisp's style. So his players continue to be fresh. The other thing the Flyers have done, again, in this third period, they've taken the crowd out of this game because of the way that they're playing.
At the end of the game, Joe and I will select the new Dodge player of the game.
They're very quiet. They're waiting for something to happen. But the Flyers, again, playing very conservative right now.
John Cullen, who suffered an arm injury in the second period, has not returned. He is done for the game. Petit played it across, picked up by Chris Therrien, and tipped over the boards into the Lightning bench, stopping play again. 6:24 remaining in the third period. Sean Podine, who's been one of the more effective players for the Philadelphia Flyers, is a good penalty killer, good checker, and scoring the odd goal.
He's always visible when he's on the ice. And Sam, speaking of visible, let's go back to John Cullen. Terry Crisp saying, for our team to be successful, we can't have just one line going or two lines going. We need our top three lines going all the time. And there again, you see Crisp behind the bench. Very vocal, animated, as you mentioned, trying to get his team going. Now we're getting some noise out of this crowd. Just 6:24 to go in this third period, and the Lightning still trailing by a goal.
Aaron Gabey on the faceoff for Tampa Bay. Driven in by David Shaw. Gabey, Klima, and Selivanov for Tampa Bay. Up the boards, Joel Otto brings it out for Philadelphia. And once again, it's over the boards into the crowd. Play stops with 6:11 to go in the third, and the Flyers leading the Lightning. I apologize for this, but this is coming from the official scorers, so they've been changing it back and forth. They've given it to Renberg again. So it is Lindros from Howardchuk and Renberg. That's the go-ahead goal at 3:20 of this third period. That's until the next change. They may give Micheletti an assist on that goal.
I need it. I've got a bonus.
Is that right? For assists, huh?
Sure.
5:40 to go in the third as the Lightning clear out, and Svoboda drives it around the boards. Hammerlick lifts it, and Dykhouse chases it down. Haller moves it. Stopped by Bellows. Good pass to Gratton. Weimer to the net. Good check by on the play by Falloon. And Falloon got knocked down. That shot by Gratton goes over the top.
What a hit by Roman Hammerlick. Falloon did a good job twice in his own zone, coming back to help out defensively. And then Hammerlick moved up to hit Falloon, and that gave the Lightning the chance.
Good pressure. Bellows took it away. Bellows and Weimer were all over Haller. Here's Brindamore. Able to move it. Missed by Corey Cross. Comes all the way down. It'll be an icing. Cross did not touch it. And icing is whistled on the Philadelphia Flyers with 4:54 to go in the third. It's a one-goal game. Jason Weimer, Brian Bellows, been kept very, very quiet. Gratton with 1 point in the game. On an assist on the Peter Klima power play goal. Hextall loved that puck, grabbing it out of the air, stopping play. They've done a good job on Brian Bradley, keeping him quiet. I don't know if the Lightning have what you would call a number one line. You know, they have a good line with Cullen, who is out injured now, and Burren Selivanov. This line of Gratton, Weimer, and Bellows has been a real good line, put together in February, and they've been together for the last 25 games of the season, done a good job.
Both those two players, Weimer on the right wing, Gratton, very young, and with the addition of the veteran on the play, Brian Bellows, who joined that line, he has really helped those two, but as you mentioned, good job by the Flyers defensively.
Peter Klima with a power play goal, Rob Zamater with a shorthanded goal and an even strength goal. The scoring for Tampa Bay. Here's Brindamore breaking out with Quinn. Tarjan trailing the play. Dan Quinn back for Brindamore. He's checked by David Shaw, allowing Reese to stop the puck, and Reese gets up after Dan Quinn came into the crease and bumped him a little bit.
And Dan Quinn did the right thing. It was a 3-on-2 break for the Flyers coming down. Didn't have much to do with it, but he kept the puck going forward. That's a time when you don't want to make flat passes across the blue line or drop passes when you're leading by a goal late in the game. So Quinn did the right thing, just moving the puck to the net. Reese had to cover up on it, and so we'll have a faceoff. Now under 5 minutes to go in this game, and a big win for the Detroit, or for the Winnipeg Jets, coming back to beat the Red Wings 4-1.
Their season in Winnipeg, they get a playoff win at the Winnipeg Arena. Chicago has defeated Calgary 7-5. Chicago leads that series 3-0, but the Winnipeg Jets will be in Phoenix next year as the Phoenix Coyotes, with a big win over the Detroit Red Wings, the number one team in the NHL in the regular season. A lot of people felt that would be a 4-game sweep. Well, a good bounce back game for Winnipeg, a 4-1 win.
Well, Winnipeg has some talented players.
That's an offside as it went out of the zone, carried back in by Desjardins.
They have some talented players, and they've got a goaltender that's come on the scene this year in the National Hockey League. Nikolai Khabibulin, the Russian goaltender, has really shown that he belongs in this league. As we've seen in years past, Sam, a goaltender can steal not only a game, but if a goaltender is hot, he can steal a series.
Yep. Puck driven in by Kevin Haller. Here's Lindros trying to tee it up. Took a bump from Bradley. Ulanov gets to it. He's knocked down by Lindros. Howardchuk shoots, and it was blocked. Ulanov with 4 minutes to go in the third period. Flyers leading 4-3. Desjardins plays it in the Tampa Bay zone. Ulanov works his way out. Igor Ulanov fires in. Haller loved it, dropped it, laid it out.
The Flyers have also done a good job on Roman Hammerlick in this game. We haven't mentioned his name all that much, but he's a player that can follow up the play from the defense and really help out offensively.
Rob Zamater took that last shot from Tampa Bay. This is Lindros, 3-on-2 across the line. Lindros plays it in front and went all the way through, trying to get it through to Trent Platt. Ryan Bradley, pass broken up by Carl Dykhouse. Lindros the other way. Sean Podine after it. Takes it around. Up around. Try a stop by Reese. Good speed by Sean Podine.
And then he made an excellent play behind the net to beat the Tampa defenseman. And he was able to walk out around the side of the net, get it in front. He had another Flyer teammate there with him. And Jeff Reese was able. Here it is again. Podine looking behind the net. Beats two Tampa players. Trent Klatt, number 20, is also there for Philadelphia. And Reese able to make the save.
Here's what the Western Conference playoffs look like right now. Detroit leading 2-1, game four in Winnipeg. Colorado leading 2-1 over Vancouver, game four in Vancouver. Chicago leading 3-0 over Calgary, game four in Calgary. And tonight, game three, Toronto at St. Louis. That series tied a game apiece. What do you think's gonna happen in that series, Joe?
Well, it's difficult to say at this point. It would give St. Louis the edge because they win a game on the road and they have the home ice advantage, but then they lose Grant Fuhr. And it's gonna be St. Louis to win that series without Grant Fuhr because he's been their savior all season.
Hammerlick to David Shaw. Time winding down on the Lightning. Philadelphia leading 4-3. In comes Aaron Gabey with room. Save Hextall, he's got it. Challenging play by Ron Hextall. Gabey got room. And he almost tied it.
That's an excellent save by Ron Hextall. He hasn't been tested all that much in this game, but he has to come up with a big save here. Philadelphia turning the puck over in the neutral zone. Gabey with some time. He let go quick wrist shot. Look where Hextall was. He was a good 10 feet out of the crease to cut down the angle. He did the right thing because he just got a piece of the puck, and then he was able to cover up. Excellent save by Ron Hextall.
3:01 to go in the third as you look at Ron Hextall's numbers this afternoon. Man who led the NHL in goals against average, 2.17. Aaron Gabey's got a big scar on his face, had a huge accident in the game up in Buffalo, fell down and was cut by his teammate, Michel Petit. Another shot is a good save. Selivanov took that shot. Hextall with another good save.
Took 120 stitches in the face, 3 hours of surgery.
Chris Therrien up the boards. Lindros seeing a lot of time. Otto moving in on David Shaw. Podine to the net. He went down on the play. Barreling into Jeff Reese. There's a crowd in the goal. Play continuing, and Podine gets out. Puck still alive. 2.5 minutes to go in the third. 4-3 Philadelphia. Otto takes a hit. Rather, it was Clyde who was hit. Podine's in the corner. Podine comes away with the puck, chased by David Shaw, pulled him down. Nothing called on the play. Hammerlick able to clear the zone. Trent Klatt did a good job in the neutral zone, but lay across. Bradley stopped by Shel Samuelson, who takes the puck away and clears it with 2 minutes to go in the third.
Excellent defensive play by Shel Samuelson. He's big, tall, he has that long reach, and the smaller Brian Bradley could not beat him.
Hammerlick clears the zone. Bounces past Desjardins. Bellows going for the puck. Desjardins able to move it to Kevin Holler with 1:45 to go. Puck knocked down by Petit in center, taken back by Brindamore. Brindamore moves in, makes the shot, now takes it. Reese makes a good save. Lightning clear out. Bellows, nice pass to Gratton. Gratton moves against Desjardins. Gratton goes wide, backhands it in front, deflected, a save made by Hextall. May have gone off a skate. I don't know if it was deflected with a stick by Bellows. Pushing and shoving following. And the linesman settled things down, 1:24 to go.
That's an excellent save again. Brian Bellows was covered. He had his back to Hextall in front. Still able to get his stick somehow on the puck. He guessed right. And meanwhile, just prior to that, Sean Podine gets pulled down, and he slides into Jeff Reese. Jeff Reese has his left hand going, kind of rubbing the head of Podine, trying to get him out of there.
How do you play goal like that?
And still watch the play.
Ryan Bellows made an unbelievable play. There's a timeout. I believe the Lightning have called timeout. Now they're gathering in front of the bench. We have a delay here. Well, Reese has called the linesman back. As they check out the ice in the crease. 1:24 to go. Washington and Pittsburgh play game three in Washington, with the Caps having won 2 games on the road, led by the great goaltending of Olaf Kolzig, Mario Lemieux and Jaromir Jagr have not had a goal in the first two games of that series.
Washington Capitals have been in their face. They've stayed close to them. They've attacked the puck, and they're not giving Pittsburgh any time to make plays.
1:24 to go. Terry Murray checks things out. We'll see if and when Jeff Reese goes to the bench for an extra skater. He's looking to the bench for instructions. Bradley on the faceoff against Brindamore. Loose puck. Bellows shoots and scores! Brian Bellows, the man who won game two, has tied it with a minute 19 to go. Bellows on the bouncing puck, and the Lightning come in.
Now Selivanov's over here. He makes the play here. Watch him come in. It's a tie on the faceoff. Selivanov with the shot, and Bellows is just able to wind his way through and get the rebound. Again, here's the play over here going this way. There's the shot. Bellows, no one takes him. And he's just able to bang away at it and put it past Ron Hextall to tie this game with 1:19 to go.
The Lightning took a 1-0 lead in this game. The Flyers scored three straight, led 3-1. Tampa Bay came back to tie it 3-3. The Flyers took the 4-3 lead early in the third, and now the Lightning have tied it. Aaron Gavy's pass blocked. Hextall fires off the glass. Less than a minute to go in regulation time. As the puck bounces down in the corner, Chris Therrien hounded by Aaron Gavy. Down by Gavy, but a whistle had blown for an offside with 50 seconds remaining. And if this ends in a tie in regulation time, we'll have a full intermission before going to sudden death overtime.
And the crowd here on their feet. This Lightning team, there just simply is no quit.
No.
They won't give up. Again, there's the tie on the faceoff. Selivanov comes in. He's 29. No one takes Bellows going to the net. That's a defensive mistake. You've got to keep one defenseman in front of the net.
And Hextall left the rebound.
That's right.
And a good play by Bellows. Bellows from Selivanov and Bradley at 18:41 to tie it. 35 seconds to go. Therrien back for the puck for Philadelphia. And they are going wild here at the Thunderdome. Puck played up into the crowd. 26.8 seconds remaining in regulation time. Trent Platt has had a goal in this game. Terry Crisp has kept his team in it. And Brian Bellows, the man who's playing his 108th playoff game, comes through.
How about the frustration of the Flyers? They have outshot Tampa Bay 42-27 in this game. As you mentioned, the early lead looked like Jeff Reese was going to have a difficult afternoon. He has responded tremendously to make numerous big saves.
Playoff record of 25,945 here at Thunderdome.
I was going to say, Sam, that allowed his team to come back and tie this game.
Waiting, plays it across. And this one, 5 seconds away from overtime. Halibut for the second consecutive game. The Flyers and Lightning go to overtime. Aaron Gavy, a strong effort, but it's Brian Bellows, the man who comes through with the tying goal. Brian Bellows scores with a minute 19 to go in regulation time. The teams go to the locker rooms to collect themselves for overtime. James Brown and Dave Maloney are standing by in our studios in Hollywood. First, we'll have a few messages and then back to Hollywood for our overtime intermission.
post-game show with Dave Maloney. I'm James Brown. Let's show you what you have seen indeed. 25,000 plus at the Thunder game.
At the Thunderdome, and they're waving and rocking this afternoon, JB. This put the Flyers up 2-1 the second period. Trent Klatt following by Joel Otto. Now the Flyers get guilty of everybody going one way, the puck going the other. Rob Zomner, his second goal of the hockey game. That was a shorthanded tally. Right here now puts the Flyers up 3, turn around, redirected by Eric Lindros. That was early in the third, but off the power play, watch Bellows here sneak away, puck bounces, he bats it in. Brian Bellows has tied this hockey game up late in the third period, and that's why we're heading for overtime.
All right, I guess it was a Freudian slip on my part looking to get out of here. I'm calling it a post game, and indeed it's in overtime. Philadelphia out shooting Tampa Bay 48-28, but Tampa Bay obviously playing well. Talent and skill level was upgraded with Mr. Bellows.
Brian Bellows they brought over for Mark Burrow from Montreal. Bellows is a former first-round pick, won a Stanley Cup with the Montreal Canadiens, and he's a goal scorer. He's a gritty kind of hands goal scorer. A little more physical presence than a Ray Shepard, but when he gets in low, he's going to capitalize on a chance. It's like David Andrechuk picked up for Jersey to score goals like that. He scored the overtime winner in Game 2, Brian Bellows. But you got to give Esposito and Crisp credit. This is a hockey team that's come into this playoff series. People think the Flyers are going to roll over them, but they've gritted it out. Character, they're very persistent, disciplined, and their power play has been very special also. So Tampa Bay doing a lot of the little things, the character aspects of our game real well. Overtime game 3.
And we've underscored this theme throughout the day that Tampa Bay impressively physical against a very physical team of the Flyers indeed. All right, well, the Rangers finally bucked the bad trend, led by these guys right here, winning for only the second time since 83 in Montreal.
2 power play goals and 5 chances. This was number 1 as Adam Graves sets up shop high between the hash marks and bangs this one in. Mark Messier with 2 assists. This is one of them right here. This puck is not pretty. The puck gets to the front of the net and they jam it through Thibault's legs. Thibault, big save here in the second period off the stick of Mark Messier. A bigger factor today than he was in the first 2 games in New York.
So the Rangers are back in it now, narrowing that series lead 2-1. Dave, you mentioned at the very top of the day that this Rangers team built around Mark Messier. So as such, as he goes, so goes the Rangers.
Well, that sure is the case. And as I mentioned before, the Rangers found themselves in a predicament after the 2 games. A younger, quicker Montreal club seemed to control the neutral zone. Now, Thibault today stopped 35 shots. He stopped 81 in the first 2 games. So the Rangers continued to generate some offense. I think this afternoon, JB, the Rangers were allowed a little more presence down low. It was only a 2-1 hockey game, so it wasn't like it was wide open. Breaks the Rangers' way to back in the series.
All right, and the Rangers were 2 of 7 on the power play. Detroit and Winnipeg. Yes, indeed, it's been a long time since they've gotten the cup in Winnipeg.
A long time. This is what the Russians do so well, is find the open ice seam. That's Kozlov to Larionov. But, JB, that wasn't enough today in Winnipeg. What a great behind the back, bust the seam pass by Craig Muni onto the stick of the youngster Chad Kilger. That's his first NHL goal in the playoffs. This is Eddie Olchuk, and he's going to blast this one by Mike Vernon to my way. A little bit of a surprise start for Game 3. But Winnipeg's happy. They're dressed in white. It's white outside because it's still snowing in Winnipeg, JB.
First playoff victory since April 27, 1993. Calgary and Chicago.
Calgary made this a game in the third period, but this was the second period to put Chicago up 4-0. Now you're going to see some perimeter play here. Go back to Chiasson on the point. He sneaks in. That made it 5-3. They weren't done. Corey Spillman going to slip out of the slot off the back. Forehand, beats Belfour. But talent is talented. A nice little dink pass to Daze from Roenick. Roenick, a factor in these hockey games, was not a factor in the first round last year. Chicago 7-5. You know, at the end of 2, it was 5-0. And Calgary came back, but it wasn't enough, JB.
And Calgary really did puddle in this game indeed, but only 2 teams have come back from an 0-3 deficit, so it doesn't look good. But do you think the spirit of the Flames broken in this one at all?
I think so. I think when you get back 5-4 after being 5-down, that you're on a roll. It's just Chicago's just a better hockey team, more talent.
All right. And folks, as we mentioned at the top, overtime is what we're dealing with right now between Philadelphia and Tampa Bay, and we'll bring you all of that action after this.
Shining on the Lightning. And if you don't like hockey, you can go fishing. And inside in the Thunderdome, the record crowd loving it. Their Lightning is still alive as they head for overtime in Game 3. We'll be right back. Be back at the Thunderdome. This is Game 3 on this best of seven series. Flyers and Tampa Bay Lightning, and the number eight seed, the underdog Lightning, have tied it on this goal late in regulation.
Well, here are the defensemen right here, the two Flyer defensemen. This is Brian Bellows. Now coming in this way, Peter Svoboda. Watch what happens. He lets Bellows get away from him. And then Eric Lindros, the only player in front, but Bellows just muscles his way right there. He'll go right to the front of the net. The shot will get through, and Bellows all alone gets one crack at it, gets another crack at it, and it ends up behind Ron Hextall to tie this game. Rod Brind'Amour and Brian Bradley on the draw. The initial shot from Salivanov coming off from the boards, and there's Bellows sneaking through to get his own rebound to tie this game. Brian Bellows, boy, what a season he has had.
What a job Bradley did on the big, strong Rod Brind'Amour on the faceoff.
Yeah, Rod Brind'Amour trying to kick the puck, could not do it because Bradley stayed with him. And then Salivanov coming off the boards made the play.
27,000.
Well,
the experience factor. Brian Bellows has the most play experience of any member of the Tampa Bay Lightning. He went to the Stanley Cup Finals in 1991 with Minnesota. He won a Stanley Cup Championship in 1993 with the Montreal Canadiens. And he has scored big goals in the past, and he scored a big goal Thursday night to win in overtime.
It was a Philadelphia giveaway in the neutral zone. Bellows had trouble getting control of it, but like a veteran, he stayed with it, finally got the shot off. And he said he was trying to go through the legs of Ron Hextall because he knew he was moving. And that takes a real goal score. And here's the tying goal. Look at Bellows go right for the net, fights past Peter Svoboda, and stays with it. Excellent concentration. He had a man on his back, the puck high up in the air, and he waited for the puck to come down before, again, he put it past Ron Hextall.
Set for overtime. Last season in the playoffs in 1995, the Flyers played four overtime games. In them all, three times defensemen got game-winning goals. Dykhouse, Desjardins, and Haller. And once Eric Lindros got the game winner. Pat Filloon, number 15. Filloon, Brind'Amour, and Quinn with Therrien and Samuelson for Philadelphia. The Lightning with Bratton, Weimer, and Bellows. Kamalik and Shaw. Samuelson gave it away to Bratton.
Yeah.
Bouncing puck, Filloon comes out. Dan Quinn sends it in. David Shaw whips it around the boards. Bellows waiting for it, taken away by Peter Svoboda. Otto, Platt, Filloon, and Lindros, the goal scorers from Philadelphia. Long shot by Shaw, stick save by Hextall.
Now it'll be interesting to see how these two teams play, whether they're going to play conservative like Philadelphia did in the third period. They got a little conservative. And even though they had dominated most of the face in this game, where they had won the key faceoffs for the most part, Tampa Bay wins a big one.
Joe, do you think it's easier for the Lightning to play this type of game because so little is expected of them? Everyone is expecting the Flyers to win.
Yeah, I think it's a great point, Sam. It seems like this Lightning team has been a team of destiny this season.
Here's Klima coming out with it. Stopped by Desjardins. Gets it to Mikael Anderson. Anderson against Lindros. Makes the pass to Klima. Shot blocked. Did not get through. Haller made the block. Anderson goes down, and it's cleared out by Howardchuk. Lindros, Howardchuk, and Renberg on. Desjardins and Haller. Haller's got the puck. Bradley and Salivanov are on with Zaminer. Bradley keeps it in. Zaminer with two goals in the game gets to the puck. Lays it down the boards for Salivanov. Poke checked away. Taken back by Brian Bradley. All the way across. Finds an open man, Bill Holder. Holder with the puck. His shot's blocked. Deflected. Score! Salivanov! The Tampa Bay Lightning win again in overtime and take a 2-1 lead in the series. Come from behind to tie it late and win it in overtime. They lead this series. What an incredible performance by the Lightning.
They simply will not quit. What a play by Bill Holder. There he is on the right point. He fakes the shot and he'll go down and he'll just go around and get it to the net. Now look at Selivanov right here in front. He's there and he'll just jump on the rebound and put it in. What a move by Holder. Fake shot. Desjardins goes down, the defenseman, and then in front of the net, Selivanov fighting off a check, holds his ground, puts in the rebound, and oh boy, these Tampa Bay Lightning now lead the series. Bill Holder, tremendous play. Selivanov on the rebound, and they end it quickly.
The number 8 seed, the Tampa Bay Lightning, did not make the playoffs till the next to the last day of the season. And now they lead this series against the number 1 seed. And once again, they scored on a rebound, Joe.
Ekstahl with the initial save. You just have to love the grit and determination of this Tampa team.
The Lightning, yes, sir. They lead it 2-1. They win 5-4 in overtime. In overtime, Alexander Selivanov scores the game winner. And today, the new Dodge player of the game is Alexander Selivanov. Dodge is pleased to donate $1,000 in Alexander Selivanov's name to the Amateur Hockey Association of his choice. So the playoff picture in the Eastern Conference now looks like this. The Philadelphia Flyers are trailing Tampa Bay 2-1. Washington leads 2-0. They play tomorrow night in Washington. Montreal leads the Rangers 2-1. They play Tuesday night in Montreal. Florida leads Boston 1-0. They play tomorrow night in Miami. For Joe Micheletti, this is Sam Rosen. So long from the Thunderdome.
Final. NHL on Fox will be there to bring you all the action. Catch the best players in the league as they vie for the most historic prize in all of sports. Coverage begins at 3 p.m. Eastern, 12 Pacific. Check local listings for game and time in your area on Fox. This has been a presentation of Fox Sports, home of the Stanley Cup, World Series, and Super Bowl 31.
Backhand pass to Chad Kilger. The rookie buries it. His first playoff goal in his first playoff game. Jets lead it 2-1. It's an emotional game for many of the fans at the Winnipeg Arena and for the team as well. Later, Ed Olczyk flying down the wing. He unloads with the big shot. It beats Vernon 3-1 for the Jets. Moments later, they'll put it away. Alexei Zhamnov with a cross-ice pass to Dave Manson. He won times at home. 4-1 Winnipeg. The Jets are all smiles. They're back in the series, trailing this best-of-7 series, 2-1. A key victory for Winnipeg. Nikolai Habibulin was spectacular in the Winnipeg net. He stopped 32 Detroit shots. Both teams were 0-4 on the power play. Keith Tkachuk, huge game. He scored his first goal of the playoffs. Following the contest, we had this reaction.
We allowed them to get their blue line and our blue line a little too often, and maybe played a little looser defensively, or maybe a little, little less disciplined. We've been really, really good at not giving the other team any skating room. But again, they had a couple of chances when we were down, and the fourth goal is a good example of that, where we were coming 4-on-2 rush, and we just miss, and they chip it out, and they're gone 3-on-1 the other way, and those things happen in games when you're trying to get a goal.
And how about Tampa Bay? As you saw in our air, they knock off Philadelphia by a count of 5-4. A lot of people didn't think they'd win one game, let alone two. The hero was Selivanov. He scored the winner at the 2:13 mark of OT. By the way, they set a new NHL playoff record in Tampa Bay. 25,945 fans showed up. Still to come on Sports Desk, why is Grant Fuhr skating again? We've got all the details for you. There was a hailstorm at the senior championship, and the Braves, they go to the wall against the Padres. Stay tuned.
McGinley skates away from Craven. McGinley looks to wrap it around. Belfour got the stick down to stop that. Titov couldn't hold it in. Joe Murphy with the puck. He'll backhand one into the left wing corner, and that's where Nichols is heading. He's beaten to the puck, and again, the Flames will get it out. But this time, Chicago takes over. Captain Chelly.